I want to talk a little bit about crises and opportunity today and how my script has changed since the correction. And my friend, I think this could actually be the melt up. This could be a very similar, right now could be a very similar moment to what we saw in 1998 after the crisis, actually. And now, while I agree with what all of the previous speakers have told us, I think it's a question of timing. And I think that we have this opportunity now. I think that these guys are absolutely right, but that day may be much further off. And again, they weren't actually putting a date on it that it's going to happen tomorrow or anything. It is inevitable, but inevitable doesn't have to be tomorrow. So we saw an extreme in pessimism in 1998. We also saw an extreme in pessimism after Black Monday in 1987, and we saw two other extremes since 1987. But we've only had four extremes that were as pessimistic as the extreme that we just hit at the end of August. It was shocking to me to see this in the numbers, that investors were as pessimistic at the end of August as they were after the end of Black Monday in 1987, and in the 1998 Asian crisis, and two other times. And in each of those instances, stocks went up very, very nicely for the next 18 months to 24 months. So this extreme of fear that we hit in August, and I was actually shocked that fear was that extreme, because the fall in stocks was only about 12%. So usually it takes a lot more to shock people, but I guess people are just so ready for it, and they were conditioned. And when the correction finally hit, it was like, oh, this is the big one. It's starting today. But the question is, was it the big one? Was this the beginning of the end, or is this a buying opportunity? And as I'll show you, my numbers show me that actually right now is a buying opportunity. I may be the only one that says this for the next 3 days, and I'm okay with that as a contrarian investor. But I think we do have another 18 months of actually quite possibly incredible upside. We have all three things that I look for in an investment, as I'll show you. And so if you look at my last line there, I say, throw a dart at a list of asset classes and buy whatever it lands on, okay? So I don't know if I can be much more bullish than that statement right there. But I say use a stop loss, okay? And I'll show you a couple charts of what I mean by this. But I don't know of anyone else sharing this basic idea that I'm sharing with you today. This idea of the melt-up, the idea of this is late 1998 all over again, and we could have an incredible boom that is the end, just like we saw in the 1990s, an incredible boom in stock prices. We are coming from such an extreme in fear. So here are just a couple of examples. After Black Monday, we hit this fear extreme, the sentiment extreme, which makes sense, right? I mean, the market's fallen over 20% in a day. You would think that people are rightfully scared, right? And but as you can see, stocks basically went up over the next couple years in a reasonably straight line as far as stocks go. And I think an even more likely, a better parallel is 1998, because if you think about it, stocks have gone up from 2009 to present, essentially, with the exception of that August blip. It was a pretty incredible run from 2009 to present. That's a long run. That's just like the 1990s. We had a long run without a whole lot of volatility. And this is a chart of the NASDAQ, and you can see that stocks fell pretty dramatically. They fell 19%. And then stocks, the NASDAQ index soared 200% in 18 months. So, when you have these extremes in fear, you can make a lot of money in stocks. And I believe that all of our previous presenters are correct. As I said, I think it's just a question of timing. So what you can see is the last four extremes in sentiment that are more shorter term. And what this is this is my friend Jason Geffert's website, sentimenttrader.com. And this is simply the number of indicators, the percentage of his indicators that are now at bearish extremes. And 56% of his indicators hit bearish extremes in August, which was worse than any time, even going back to March of 2009. Now, it would have been brilliant to buy stocks in March of 2009, as you know in hindsight, and I'm telling you, you have a similar type of opportunity today.